Hi, there are five what we call standard algorithms to cover. I'm going to cover linear search in this video and the other four in the next few videos. Linear search is one of our two searching algorithms. They're called standard because they are just so widespread. It's not quite the same use of a word in paper one. In paper two, they're standard because they are so common. Every computer science student will learn these five algorithms. So linear search is one of our most simple, but it is within the searching class of algorithms. So we've only got two searching algorithms, and a searching algorithm, its purpose is to see if a target item exists in a data set. The term data set refers to all of your data collectively. So it could be a massive file, it could be a database, and the target is what you are searching for specifically. At its essence, a search algorithm just confirms or denies the target is in the data set, but even the most simple ones will often also say where the target is, assuming it's found. So, my name is found at record 47 in my database. It'll tell me where it is potentially. And I kind of do and kind of don't want you to have things like these search bars in your head when learning about this topic. I kind of do because people often ask, well, what was the point of us learning about the two searching algorithms? And it's because, well, obviously there are searches everywhere in computer science. We search all the time for things. And all of these searches will be using either linear search or binary search. Part of me doesn't want you to think about these because, in all honesty, these methods of searching aren't quite the same category of search algorithms as what we're learning about here. You know, if I type in OCR GCSE Computer Science, I see loads of different videos. YouTube has ranked these videos in a particular order based on lots of other factors. And all of those other factors don't come into a classic search algorithm like linear search or binary search. So for GCSE, we're ignoring all the relevance ranking. We're just focusing on, is the target in the data set and potentially also where it is located. So how does linear search work? Well, it works by comparing each item in your data set against the target item. If the item is equal to the target item, the algorithm ends because it's found the target in the data set. If the item it's checking isn't equal to the target, then simply it checks the next item. And this works sequentially. It works one by one as it progresses through our data set. If we get to the end when all items have been checked and we haven't found our target, then I haven't found the target. And that happens, right? We search for stuff sometimes and I may get no results. Now, out of the five standard algorithms on the course, I would say this is the one you're least likely to be asked to perform because it is quite basic and quite simple. But you might be asked to show how linear search would, for example, search for 35 in this list of values. Now, how would I show this? Well, I would just do a set of bullet points. So, is 35 equal to 19? 19 is our first item. We're going to start there. No, it's not. Is 35 equal to 65? It is not. Is 35 equal to 24? It is not. Is 35 equal to 19? I'm afraid it's not. However, is 35 equal to 35? Yes, it definitely is. So because it is, I've found the target. So if I was writing an exam, I might just be really clear. I found the target item. And if it was a variant of linear search where we were looking for an actual position, if this was an array, for example, our index numbers would be this. And maybe it would also tell us, oh, I found it at index 4. But not all search algorithms will even do that. Some will just tell you either yes or no. You won't be expected to memorize the code for the exam, but you would be expected to recognize it if you saw it. And I must say that out of our five, this is the one where I think it's feasible for them to ask you to code it yourself because actually it's not the most complicated. That being said, there's no point learning an exact program for linear search. It's better to learn the principles behind it and try to understand what exactly it's trying to do. Here's my version in OCR ERL. The main things to look out for are for loops. It could be done with a while loop, but a lot of the time it's done with a for loop to iterate through each item in an array. We could still iterate through each item using a while loop. It's just typically a for loop is how this is done. But within the for loop, or indeed the while loop, we will need to have a nested if statement which can check for equality with our item in our array versus our target. Because if they are equal, that means I've found the target. And then my implementation here, I've decided to use a Boolean variable to keep track of whether it's been found or not, because at the end, I want to print out either it's found or not found. I only wanted to print this out once, which is why I didn't put it in the for loop. If I put these in the for loop, it might print it multiple times, which isn't quite what I want. By the way, nesting is when we have a block of code inside another block of code. So this if statement is nested because it's inside the for loop, whereas this if statement at the bottom isn't nested because it's not inside any other bits of code. So it could be worth you having a go at programming this yourself now, if you haven't done so already, maybe from memory, ideally. Perhaps try and implement it using a while loop, just so you've got an idea of how it would be done using this alternative type of iteration.